Don't leave it outside. God. I'm having a little bit of trouble with this plant. It has spider mites and I don't know if it's gone now. I gave it a little bit of a shower, but I also think the soil might be contained. So I think it's a good idea to just cut away the leaves that are really infected and also give it some new soil, I guess. I'm very far away. Come a little bit closer. Maybe you don't really see what I'm doing then, but hey. And I also wanted to make an update video. My 8 months on testosterone, but as you can probably hear, my voice is very low right now, and that's because I got COVID. I got tested positive a week ago, and yeah, I'm still having some symptoms. Still have a cold, and I still am very tired very quickly, and I don't really often have the flu. I basically never have the flu, so I think the antibiotics caused that my resistance has gone a little bit down, and then I got COVID, so I was more vulnerable to it. And it's been a rather, yeah, it's really been a flu. I've been really, really sick. Especially the first 2 days, I couldn't do anything, but I did do a lot of things. That's the problem with me. I can't just sit down and do nothing. And so I started working. Yeah, while I was in those, during those 2 days, I was still working. And that's my main issue. I can't stop and sit down and relax. So the third day, I really, yeah, told myself to lie on the bed and just take it easy and don't do anything. But the days after that, I just went straight back to work and doing everything. So it's vacation now, autumn break. So I think I need to take this week to, yeah, really get back on track and just relax and hopefully get this flu, get this coronavirus out of the way, because I'm still testing positive. And now I know that's a thing that you can, after corona, test positive for a very long time, but I also still have the symptoms. I'm still having a cold, like I said. So, yeah. And that's me to blame. I think if I would have taken my time off and just took my rest, then I'd probably be better right now. But it is what it is. And another thing that is also sick is this plant. Like I said, so I am going to going to see how the roots are looking and give it some new soil and dry it up a bit. Let's do that first, because otherwise the whole camera is full of drops. I'm tired. I'm not really tired. I'm gonna dry up the leaves. I'm gonna repot this little fella. Well, the funny thing is that this plant should be easy care, like it says on the label. I don't know if you can see it, yeah. But this is the only plant I'm having difficulties with. So I don't know what that's saying about me or about the plant. So there we are. Let's see if this this will help the plant a bit, because I still think it's a beautiful plant, but hope it gets better. I've had trouble with this from the beginning, so I think it might be invested when I got it, and hopefully I'll do an update my 8 months update in the upcoming week when my voice is a little bit better, when I'm a little bit better. There was a question I got about if my hair is turning more gray. I already answered it in the comments, but yeah, I think so. I think my hair is turning more gray, but that might not be from the testosterone. It's just my hair is getting a lot grayer the last few years, and especially when I haven't been to a barber for a couple of weeks, you can really tell. But yeah, as you can see, my hair is really gray, but I am still happy as long as I have hair. I'd rather have gray hair than no hair, but we'll see how that goes. So anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm going to go back to the couch and relax a little bit for the rest of the day. See you next time.